What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are having a wonderful day today. Today's a very nice Saturday, as you can see behind me. Clouds, blue sky. What else could you ask for on a Saturday? Anyways, today's video is gonna be a little bit around the place. A little bit all over the place, you know? Because last video, I mentioned that I was gonna, you know, go a little bit more in detail about the car. So first off, before we go into detail about the car, let's go with a little background story, I should say, about myself and the reason why I got the car. So the reason why I got the car was because I grew up around cars my whole life, you know. I was my dad was a car guy, my uncle's a car guy, you know, my family just car people, you know. And I'm Puerto Rican, so I don't know if you guys heard about how the car scene is in PR, but it's amazing, guys. It's amazing. Anyways, I grew up around cars, and I grew up, you know, I was born in 1999 when the first Fast and Furious movie came out. So it's you know, that's basically how every car guy's life starts, you know, with Fast and Furious. So I basically fell in love with Hondas because of Fast and Furious, because when I first saw the movie, I was like, what, maybe 6, 7, I don't know, I wasn't sure, it was a long time ago. But when I first saw the movie, I asked my dad about the black heist cars they use, right? So I was like, Bob, what are those cars? He was like, those are Honda Civics. I was like, oh, a Honda Civics. So I decided I should, you know, I looked them up. And I did a whole bunch of research, and ever since that day, it's just been over, man. Fell in love with the Honda Civics. So yeah, after that, that's when I fell in love with the Hondas. Honda has been in my life for as long as I can remember. So now this is where we come to the part for the reason why we bought this car. Maybe when I was like, let's see, maybe like 12 13, my dad didn't live with us, you know. My dad was living by himself in a farm that his friend, you know, lent him so he could live in. And and we used to go visit every time, you know. We used to go visit, and you know, my dad never. So, and my dad, you know, never had a car. So one summer, one spring, I don't remember, we pulled up, and he had I believe it was a 93, it's a year older than this. He had a 93 Civic in red. Like, just like this, sitting on steelies, lowered, with both, you know, front and back lip, no side skirts, you know, had a red hood, red everything, you know, the car was one color, you know, had faded fenders, you know, they were turning pink, had the sunroof, had a racing steering wheel, you know, my dad, you know, had that car, you know, good. And I fell in love with that car, man. Fell in love with it. That car had a single cam, like this one. It had this single cam. My dad's car would rip ass, man. That fucking single cam, I don't know what the fuck this single cam had. But that single cam, I think that transmission had an LSD single cam. LSD transmission, I believe. She's calling.
I believe his single cam had an LSD transmission in it. I don't know how you check this one has an LSD transmission, but this one is a D16Z6. I believe his was a D15 something. I don't know, some weird D series. But that fucking single cam would haul ass, man. You know, both wheels spinning, burnt third gear burnouts. It was just crazy, man. You know. And what I like is that, you know, it has similarities. It's a single cam. It's red. It's electric everything, sunroof. Hopefully this car will turn out like how I wanted my dad's car to look like. Because he said he would pass it down to me when I had my license, and he sold it for the most stupidest reason. He sold it because the paint was faded. And after he sold it, I got mad at him, whatever. But those who know me, those friends who know me, knows that he is not here with us anymore. It's the reason why I have this tattoo, which is his name. It says Freddy. So he's now looking down on me. He is now taking care of me. He now knows that I have a car that looks just like his, and he will bless me in this car because he knows that all I want is to have a nice car, fast car, and do whatever the fuck I want with this car, man. So I'm gonna finish doing what me and him couldn't do. I'm gonna build this as much as I can. And you guys are gonna be along for the ride. So stay tuned for what's coming in the future, guys. So, like I said in the beginning of the video, like I said, this video is gonna be all over the place, kinda. Boredom hits, guys. And since I'm gonna be getting a whole bunch of new body parts for this, I'm gonna have to get a new bumper, and I'm gonna have to get a new rear bumper. So today, guys, we're gonna try to cut my rear bumper. So I don't know if you guys seen, you know, how some Hondas are cut from right here, the bumpers, right? So that's what I'm gonna try to attempt. You see, this is a crappy bumper. This is why I'm saying I might have to get a new bumper. So why not try to, you know, try to experiment with this crappy one. So I'm gonna take it off, see how far I have to cut, and let's get this cut. His helper is right there. She's gonna help me out, guys. So yeah, we're gonna try to take it off, and let's see if I could put this on a time lapse, because I'm still new to this recording stuff. So let's see if my time lapse ain't crap.
It's the bad thing about old cars, man. Everything gets stuck. I just sprayed a little bit of WD-40 on it. These things don't come off. I don't want to strip it because that strips, I'm fucked. So get back to you in a few.
So I managed to get the back bumper and also the rear bumper support off, just in case. If anything, I'll put it back on. Sorry I didn't film because my phone died. I didn't charge it last night. Still on low percent, just had to, you know, film. But I managed to get it off. Now, see how far I have to cut. So this is how far I got. Try to do the straightest line that I can. But guys, like I said, this is a learning experience on a bumper that already looks like crap. So, you know, this is how I'm gonna do it. I gotta put tape on. There's a curvature, there's a line under the tape, like a body line. So that's where I marked with the marker on top of the tape. And I don't know how this shit curved all the way over there. But like I said, guys, it's a learning experience. I'm trying to do the best I can because I've never cut a bumper. So I just changed the blade on the machine, and let's get the cutting. There's officially no turning back with this fucking bumper. I went ham. Don't mind my pink slides. They're my girls. Anyways, there is no turning back from this bumper. This bumper is a complete fuck up. But guys, like I said, it's a learning process, you know? I don't care if you guys bash me in the comments saying that I did it wrong, but I don't give a shit. Because I'm learning. Take off the tape, sand the edges a little bit, see if I can smooth that out, and then mock it up, see how it looks, and I'll show you guys. This looks sick. I did a good job for my first time, you know? Doesn't look that bad. I just don't know whether to put the bumper support back on. Yes, it's just mocked up, not bolted on or anything, but it looks pretty nice. I ain't gonna lie. Damn. Guys, should I lower it a little bit more to clear that gap? I don't know. It's not that low. Doesn't scrape. But damn. I did a good job. Now you can see the control arms a little bit more. Let me bolt it back up, guys. I'll come back in a few. Pancho, what you think about the bumper? Huh? What you think? Can you see it from there? What you think? Huh? No? Alright, now it is all finished, guys. All bolted on. No support. That's going to the garbage. It looks way nicer. You can now see the control arms. I gotta give it a little clean. That's getting painted, cleaned and painted red again. I'm telling you guys, this car is gonna change a lot. Car looks from the side, looks so nice. I love this car already, man. It looks so nice. Guys, I'm gonna end the video out here. I'm gonna have to see you guys tomorrow, because tomorrow I got a video for you guys tomorrow. You guys are gonna see an Inspire Accord. One of my boys are coming through to help me out restore my carbon private hood. And he has a fucking sick ass Inspire 07 Accord. So you guys will see that tomorrow. Oh, and it's bagged too. So you guys are gonna hear a little action. So stay tuned for tomorrow's video, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.